guys. Welcome to the first episode of the Horsin' Around Comedy Podcast. I'm with my two co-hosts here, Ryan and Ben.
Yo, I'm Ryan.
It's your boy, Ben.
And, yeah, this is Horsin' Around Comedy Podcast.
It's very epic.
It is very epic. This has been a long time in the making, yeah.
Very long. We finally have the setup, and it's beautiful.
Yeah, we do have the setup, and it's very nice. What does Ryan have to say?
Very nice.
Okay,
very
good. Nice.
Yeah, thank you for that input.
I love the input. Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
This would be incomplete without you.
I'll be here all week.
Oh, will you?
Yes.
You'll be staying at my house?
Yep.
I don't have anywhere for you
in
to stay.
In your basement.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
I'll
I'm okay.
Just crawling on the ceilings and shit.
Hanging on the ceilings?
Yeah.
This is a drop ceiling, so I think it would fall with the amount of weight that you have on your body.
He's calling you fat.
I have perfect equilibrium.
I don't even know what that means, but okay.
He's calling you fat.
I'm not even calling him fat. I mean,
every time you come down to the basement, it's like horror movie type shit.
For anyone who doesn't know what the movie he is trying to portray, that is
Star Wars: A New Hope.
No, it's Jurassic Park.
No, that was Jaws.
Right.
We know.
Oh, okay. Making sure you both know.
/whoosh. #r/whoosh.
All right. So what's the goal of this podcast? Well, to have fun and make people laugh.
Something we're not good at.
But yeah, something none of us are good at.
Definitely not.
Yeah, but, you know, we're going to try, all right? We got a new platform, right?
Exactly.
New way to express ourselves.
A way for our voices to get carried into your ears.
Correct.
And probably break your eardrums.
Oh, that is correct.
Possibly.
So, let's crack on into it. Just going to pull up a document here I got on my my MacBook Pro
his
2017.
Is it better than the
Surface Pros?
Surface Pro 6?
# Pope Francis sucks. Yes, it is.
Yes.
All right, great.
Now that we got that out of the way. Let's talk about the new Star Wars movie.
Oh, yes.
Which we have not seen.
We're going to see it right after we do this podcast.
Yes.
And, yeah. So, I do have, some opening thoughts on that.
What do you got to say?
So, my aunt, who loves Star Wars because she grew up with them,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
She went to see it a few nights ago.
Yeah.
She didn't spoil it for me. But if there's anyone I can trust a review on Star Wars, it's her.
It's from her, right?
Right, and she loved it. But going into this for myself, I know there's something in the movie is going to piss us off. Just one thing.
Probably.
So the entire movie
from The Last Jedi.
Yeah.
The entire movie.
I mean, this is
okay, Mr. Letdown over here.
I'm just fucking with you.
What I heard is the first act is really bad. The pacing is terrible and the writing is not very good, but then it kind of picks up afterwards and it gets really good.
Where did you read this off of? Is this did you cite your sources correctly?
I was just browsing Instagram.
Did you cite your sources correctly, though? Did you use MLA format?
Oh, no. I got to go back to Miss Nemec's class.
Oh, God.
Let's not bring her into my thoughts. I think it's going to be better than The Last Jedi, but not as good as Force Awakens.
It's not that hard to be better than The Last Jedi.
Anything is better. I heard that
there's
callbacks to Anakin.
Oh, because
through Rey.
Okay, so he's trying to end all of that series right there.
Which is good.
Yes.
So he's going to have definite callbacks to the prequels. Definitely.
Yeah, definitely. I'm wondering if Baby Yoda will make an appearance.
True. As an older...
As an older Yoda, finally?
Yeah. Yeah.
In The Mandalorian with him?
He'd be he'd be 80 years
Speaking
old.
Speaking of The Mandalorian, I still have yet to see them.
It starts off slow.
Well, my girlfriend got Disney Plus when she got her new phone for Christmas, and I said, sauce me that Disney Plus password.
The third episode is really good.
Yep. Yeah.
We're going to go see that tonight. It's going to be good to know.
How many of us?
It's four of us, right?
Five.
Who's the fifth?
Us three, Derek and...
Oh, Derek is coming.
And Derek
Aaron Flanders. Those two will maybe be guests on the show?
They'll hopefully, yeah.
Yeah, we can definitely get them on guests, yeah.
definitely need Aaron. Aaron's funny.
Oh my god,
he says funny shit.
The stuff he says. Sometimes.
He says funny shit.
Like that song. Have you heard that song where it's the guy from the video game, but it's a song?
There are several guys.
The Skyrim one?
No, it's like stop. You've broken the law.
Oblivion.
Oblivion. Yeah.
Oblivion.
Still. Elder Scrolls.
It's a very popular TikTok song, if you didn't know that. Because I'm very active on TikTok.
Before TikTok.
Oh, it was way popular. It's got like 3 million views on YouTube. It's very popular on TikTok. Not that I know anything about TikTok.
You know, gross. Man, gross.
TikTok's not that bad.
TikTok. Gross. Watch them make a TikTok movie.
Hey, speaking
of cringy entertainment. Movie,
let's talk about the Playmobil movie.
Wait, did that just come out?
Yeah, that movie tanked.
Wait, that's a thing?
Yeah, Playmobil movie. They tried to ride the success of Playmobil.
All right, hold on. Let me pull up
audio?
No. Rotten Tomatoes.
Oh god.
And we're going to see what
Ryan, you can predict. Predict before he tells us. Audience score?
Less than or equal to 19.
For
critics.
I'm going to say I'll do the audience then. 20% for audience.
Between 20
I think,
and 40.
Did it come out already?
It should have.
All right, so what are you thinking?
I said 20% for audience.
Okay.
He said
somewhere between 20 and 40 for audience.
I'm going to say.
Let me look here. Hold
like
on.
15% for the critics.
Definitely not more than 20.
Yeah.
So just so I get this correctly, it's 17%. Tomato meter, which I think is critic.
Yeah, that's critic.
And then 62% is the audience.
What?
Because it's basically a ripoff of the Lego movie. They're just trying to capitalize on.
But it's a kids movie, and kids don't have standards.
But the parents that go to see it.
Who made the
Playmobil? They sleep through the whole thing. It doesn't matter for kids. They're probably writing it based on like if their kid enjoyed it.
Probably. Only 62% liked it, I guess.
Whoa.
You can't listen to what the critics say for anything.
No,
like
Last
critics...
Jedi, 91%. Yeah. Go fuck yourself. Like, come on.
Oh, but it's like... Animation Studios. What?
Generic Animation
Studios. Hold on, I read that wrong. I completely read that wrong.
What is it? Film. Is it Blue Sky? Or,
it doesn't even tell me who made it. Yeah, production company Method Animation. Never even heard of them. You know what Google's telling me? Bad. Is Playmobil owned by Lego? No, they're not. Playmobil is its own company. Speaking of Playmobil, if you look up, I got a Playmobil guy sitting up there still.
Well, they can't see in the podcast.
Well, yeah, I'm talking to you, dude.
Oh, all right. Well, looks pretty good.
So, like I was saying, like you can't listen to what critics say at all.
Yeah.
Because, like,
the audience
score. Yeah, because Rise of Skywalker's got 55%.
And then like, audience score is 86%.
Yeah.
But, like, also, like, there are some movies
Frozen
that are, like...
Frozen 2 has 77%?
Click it, see what the audience says.
But,
though.
Like, also, like, there are some movies
92.
That are, like,
yeah. That makes sense. It's a kid's movie.
What movies?
Like, some movies are meant to be stupid.
That is
like,
true.
They're meant
That's
to be
true,
so
yeah.
bad that they're good.
But not the critics... on... Well, The Room is an exception.
It wasn't intentional.
No.
But it was so bad, it's good.
Oh, let's talk about Cats. 55% audience and 17%.
That's probably one of the lowest scores I've ever seen from critics.
Actually, I've seen a few 0% movies, but I don't remember which ones.
0% I think would be like... Oh, I know a 0% movie. That one that came out... Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly, where they were...
Oh,
in
the
like the
Sherlock Holmes?
Yeah.
Whatever. Yeah,
Holmes and Watson.
Close.
Holmes and Watson. It was a very low, but that movie was very funny. I found that movie to be funny, because it's those two. But let's think about it. Every movie they've been in together, it was never that good. It became a cult classic like 5 years later.
Yeah.
Like, let's look at Talladega Nights. Wasn't a success, but
after years.
And then like
years.
Step Brothers.
Because it's like a generation thing, I think.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
Or, like, nowadays people, like, they like irony, like, that type of humor.
Irony. Baby.
You know Will Ferrell wanted to make Talladega Nights 2, but they shut it down in favor of Daddy's Home 2?
Which actually did financially well.
Yeah. You know Daddy's Home 2 was filmed
Berkshires.
Yeah, in the Berkshires. I wanted to go.
Oh, wow.
Fun fact for you, I stalked Robert Downey Jr. when he was filming The Judge.
And we'll just cut it there. No context.
I found out that he was filming in Mass, and I went to all the shooting locations until I could find him. I never found him, but I did meet that guy from Jurassic World that wanted to take the raptors and make them into the military. I met that guy.
Oh, that guy, the fat guy.
Yeah, the fat guy. He was super nice. He walked over to us. After the production crew was like, "You guys got to be quiet," he goes, "Guys, fuck off, okay? They want to. I'm being serious. That's what he told the guy. He goes, "Fuck off. They want autographs and pictures. I'll let them have pictures. I got 5 minutes before I gotta go on set." So I got a picture with him.
What a wholesome guy.
I know exactly. That's exactly what I'm talking about. What else can we talk about?
So the SpongeBob movie.
Oh yeah.
Are we trying to see that?
The third one is coming out. Yeah.
We're trying to see that.
Yeah.
First of all, what do you think? We got to talk about the first two before going
into Let's talk about the trailer about Keanu Reeves.
Oh, my God. Uh-huh. Wait, what did you guys think of the second one?
Peep the Logic song, Keanu Reeves. Because
I know we all love the first one.
I actually, haven't seen that one.
I own it.
The first one?
The second one.
Sponge Out of Water?
Yeah.
It's okay. The animation looks good for Nickelodeon standards.
Yeah.
When it first came out, one of my classmates, we were in, the 7th or 8th grade when that came out.
Sponge Out of Water came out 3 years ago, dude.
It came out during high school.
High school.
The first one came out.
What am I
school.
Thinking about?
You're thinking of the first one. First one came out in 04.
Not 04?
Yeah, it is 04.
It came out in 04.
That early?
Yeah, hold on. Let me look it up.
Someone said
2012 was Sponge Out of Water, I think. Or 2010.
No, 2015.
That's a big gap for a SpongeBob movie.
SpongeBob SquarePants movie.
That's when the show was shit, so they couldn't.
2004.
Sponge Out of Water was 2015.
Yeah.
When What's His Face came back, the creator.
Steven Hillenburg.
Yeah,
rest in peace.
In eighth grade. So, eighth grade.
Oh, yeah.
I could have swore I was in high school.
No, this was late eighth grade.
So that makes more sense. That makes more sense now. Yeah, that makes sense.
Because I remember one of my classmates said, he went to see it, and whoever did the animation or, wrote the plot was, on LSD.
It's not like that, though.
It's actually a pretty good movie, not gonna lie.
Yeah, you could tell they put time and effort into it.
Unlike the Dora movie.
You saw that?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Unlike YouTube Rewind.
Let's talk about the best YouTuber, PewDiePie.
PewDiePie is the best YouTuber.
PewDiePie!
Yeah, I wish he still did that.
PewDiePie.
He does. He did it in his last couple of videos.
Yeah, as a
PewDiePie, little... Markiplier, and Jacksepticeye. They're the real ones of YouTube.
They are. They're
the ones
who
actually
subscribe to.
The ones who actually care about their fan base.
Yep.
Everybody else is just money, 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 money.
Yeah.
Well, not everyone.
SS Sniper
cares,
Wolf.
He cares. Mini Lad.
How about
that entire group, the Vanoss group and Mini Lad? It seems like they care, but
you know who actually cared about
it? The content's not going anywhere right now.
No, it's not.
It's still entertaining, but it's the same stuff.
You know who actually cared about their his fans, but then his fans gave up on him? Who's the guy that did the Rage Dad? And he always smashed his Xbox and ran it over with lawnmowers.
Oh yeah, yeah.
You know who I'm talking about?
I know what you're talking about. I don't know what his name is, though.
Yeah, his fans actually cared about it. They, didn't care about his new content, so he's, quitting YouTube, January 2020.
That happens.
He's got, 5 million subscribers, though. He's making money.
Oh, Dom, you like how PewDiePie mentions in his video, "I'm just going to take a short break."
The media is saying he quit.
He's quitting. But yeah, you know who's a funny YouTuber on the topic of YouTubers?
Chontron.
Well, that's a given. Every video he makes turns into a meme.
It does.
Some way, shape, or form.
Filthy Frank was funny in his prime.
In his prime.
Now he's doing music.
And now he's just, he's all right.
But you know who, Poofisher? He does Wii videos on Wii Sports Resort, and he just rages.
Oh, you show me one of these. He just uses.
He's got. He just uses. He's like a 35-year-old guy that sits in his room, and just plays Wii.
And he's got tons of subscribers.
He's got a million. He just hit a million.
Yeah, see what the Wii can do for you? Wii Sports?
Wow.
Hence my video on my channel.
Yeah, yours has gotten, the Wii one specifically,
has gotten a shit ton of views.
Because people are still interested in the Wii for some reason.
Because you know why?
Wii Sports is
why?
It's timeless. That's why.
Yeah, Wii Sports Club on the Wii U sucked ass.
I never got to use it because you could only use it with Wii Motion Plus, so I never got to use it.
And you had to use the gamepad for golf. Which I can kind of understand. Oh, you look down at the ball. I can understand that. But you had to use it for, like, boxing and stuff, too. You had to, like, shake the Wii U gamepad around, which is stupid.
Instead of using Wiimotes?
Yeah.
So that was a failed experiment, then.
But, you know what? I was at, where was I? Right before Christmas, I was at Target? Was I at Target? Target or Best Buy. One of two with my dad getting Christmas gifts. And they had Wii, Just Dance 2020, which is going to be the last game made on the Wii, which is kind of cool.
What a way to go out. What a way to go out.
And the support for the Wii U has stopped way before that.
The Wii community, I think, is growing.
The Wii community?
Is growing. Younger generations are learning about the Wii, and they're loving it. Hence why you go into GameStop and you find like no copies of Wii Sports, Wii Sports Resort.
Well, Wii Sports was
I lost my copy of Wii Sports.
Yeah, Wii Sports was a pack-in title.
But they go in, they buy a Wii. Like, GameStop doesn't sell packages in the stores, only online.
Yeah, that kind of sucks.
Which, speaking of GameStop, they're closing more stores.
I think the one on Boston
Road. They have 6,000 stores, dude. I hope the one in East Long Meadow doesn't close. Because the guy told me, he goes, we're the number one store in Western Massachusetts. We do the most money. We do the most of everything.
Well, then they wouldn't close that one.
Yeah, but you don't know. Maybe it's like Chrysler. In 08, when they hit the gas crunch, Chrysler started taking away franchises. Like my grandfather, they took away his franchise. They said, you're done.
You see, if GameStop wasn't so shit to its customers, then they probably would
have
done better.
Oh, they don't. We're gonna give you you have a $40 game.
We have 60 games in mint condition. We're only gonna give you like a paperclip and a piece of string for it.
Honestly,
At least give them like 95% of what they paid.
No,
fair trade-in.
No, like I traded it. You know what? Though the only thing they'll give you trade-in value, like good trade-ins, like Pokemon, which I traded on Pokemon Black and White. And I got $50 a piece for them. And they sold them for $75 a piece.
Wait, they sold it more than what you...
Yeah, no, because... Bad. No, it's on the DS, and those games are kind of rare.
Oh, the DS...
That was with just the cartridge.
Pokemon
that was with no case.
Running shit on the DS.
Still kind of
They're still running shit.
But I think the Switch is taking over the DS life.
True.
I'm going to still buy a 2DS. Not gonna lie, I had a 2DS. I sold it. I sold it to buy my PS4, which I barely play.
Yeah, you
just got just for Spider-Man.
I got it for Spider-Man and Call of Duty.
True. Yeah.
Yeah, we've played that a few times.
I still haven't
set up
PS Plus.
PS Now? You mean?
Is that what they call it?
Isn't it PS Now? I don't know.
PS Plus.
That's kind of a dumb name.
I don't own a PS4. I only have Xbox and a Switch.
I own every generation of
equivalent to Xbox Live.
Are you going to trade in your Xbox to get the new Xbox?
No, well, I'm keeping the old generation.
I love mine. Well, I think they're going to do stuff like the 360. They're still going to make games alongside, like they did for the,
Eventually
they'll be like, we're cutting support.
I'm keeping like my Xbox One for like my brother. Cause like I told you I'm moving out, right?
Yeah. You're moving into the apartment there.
Take the new, the new Xbox, I'll just get that.
You got another Xbox?
No.
When it comes out.
Oh, you're going to get that?
He'll just use that. He'll give his
brother. Dude, it looks like a computer tower, which is kind of pissing me
off. Hopefully
it's
powerful, though. That's all I care about.
It looks like a fridge, man.
Yeah, the Xbox One S is very powerful. You can run 4K, but I don't have a 4K TV.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah. No, as long as, like, the new Xbox is, like, super
good.
Yeah. That's all I care about.
I think it will be.
I don't care about the look.
But, like... The name is kind of stupid. Xbox One, not
Xbox Series
One,
X.
Xbox
not, Series X.
Yeah, it's kind of
like
a stupid name.
Do you have Xbox in the name? Why do you need another X?
I don't know.
Xbox X.
It's just stupid. But yeah.
All right.
Right.
Cool.
What's next on the agenda?
MCU.
Oh,
talk about. Let's just talk about Black Widow.
Oh yeah, the new Black Widow trailer looked amazing.
Yeah, it did look good.
It did.
Right.
Right.
Right. Is that all we have to see? Honestly,
Black Widow. Here's a bit of a hot take. That's one of the only Phase 4 movies I'm looking forward to.
Yeah, what are the other ones planned?
There was, like, The Eternals, which I don't care about. The new Thor movie, which I don't care about.
No.
And it's all, like, Disney Plus movies. It's all, like...
No. Disney Plus shows. The movies are still...
Yeah, that's what I mean.
But like, Disney... I'm excited about Winter Soldier and Falcon, that show.
Yeah, that one.
That one I'm excited
about. Yeah. I'm a little pissed they didn't give it to Winter Soldier, but I understand there's another version where he gives it to Falcon.
They were both Captain America.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah. I think Falcon's cooler as Captain America because... You can still fly.
Yeah.
Flying Captain America is pretty cool.
but
Winter
thing,
Soldier is like, he should have got it. It was his first friend there.
Here's what I don't understand.
This is what I saw, like, what I read about. Was like, Sam's a good man, and Bucky's, like, the perfect soldier. So remember, like...
Balance.
I think it's, like, a callback to the first Captain America. What was his name? Dr. Erskine? He tells Steve to not be a perfect soldier but a good man,
so he gives it to the good man instead of the perfect soldier.
Yeah, something like that.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, but here's what I don't understand. Speaking like Captain,
like it's Falcon, like
Captain America. You ever notice how in every movie that Captain America's in, his shield sort of changes? Like
they update it.
No, they like it goes from like having straps to magnetic.
Oh yeah,
to straps, then back to magnetic.
Well,
it was only magnetic for, like, Age of Ultron, wasn't it?
No. It was magnetic in Avengers 1.
Was it really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh. Yeah, because they gave him a new suit.
He only went back to straps in Winter Soldier because he got his old suit. That's why he went back to straps.
And then the Stan Lee cameos. You know, where...
God rest his soul.
God rest that man's soul.
God rest ye merry Stan Lees.
Another topic we could talk about is, the new Eternals.
I mean, nothing's come out about it, has it?
No, I mean, like, predictions? What are we thinking?
I don't even know what that is. I don't really follow the comics.
I don't follow. You read the comics, don't you?
I don't know much about the Eternals. But
is it about the creation of the...
It's going to deal with, like, Celestials, which are, like, godlike beings.
Is it going to be, like, the creation of the Infinity Stones or something like that?
Probably not. It's just going to deal with, like, the godlike, like, the crazy godlike shit. In the Marvel Universe. So, fun fact, Thanos is actually an Eternal in the comics.
In the comics.
Is he really?
Okay.
Yeah. He's also a mutant.
Oh, really?
In this one, they just made him
mutant.
But in this one, they just made... In the MCU...
I want to see Deadpool in the MCU.
Well, I mean, they own
He's
Fox,
not going to be as good.
Yeah, because...
Unless he's R-rated. Which I don't.
They already sent out a confirmation that they will keep his solo movies rated R.
Okay, because like they said that, but then they like backtracked on it.
And then they said it again.
Yeah.
Initially, they were like,
Deadpool.
We can't do
if
it.
He's not R rated, Deadpool will not work.
Which we already know from his PG-13 Christmas special.
Yeah.
Well, that one that was actually pretty funny. Even still, as it was PG-13, it was still kind of funny.
But it didn't do
no. It didn't
as
do
good as the two.
Didn't
movies.
Just do as good as him saying, "What the ass?
What in the actual ass?"
Yeah, when he says that kind of shit, it's
a metal arm. It's not like we're trying to remove a mustache.
And the like, what's gonna happen when he? You know how he used to diss Fox and diss Disney.
He's still gonna do.
Is he still gonna do it?
Hopefully, he still does it.
Or Disney's gonna monetize
it. Fox was totally fine with him dissing themselves.
The fact that he dissed the DC. EU when he shot himself while reading the Green Lantern, which they're making a new Green Lantern.
Wait,
movie.
How would that work in the timeline though?
It would
he shot
man.
Ryan Reynolds, you know, who plays Deadpool.
Oh,
Ryan Reynolds plays Deadpool?
Oh my god, man!
What?
I thought it was just Deadpool playing Deadpool.
What? But like, that's it. There's no Deadpool because he shot Ryan Reynolds.
Unless...
if this is how that works.
Time travel never works in movies.
Listen, man.
There's always loopholes to any time travel movie.
Pretty much, yeah.
But, like, I don't know what I'm going to say.
You can move on to the next segment.
That's all the topics I had. All
right.
Oh, all right.
Let's just talk about anything.
Anything.
Bring up a topic. Let's
Rip Juice WRLD.
I know, Rip Juice WRLD.
Yeah, RIP, man.
Rip the man, the myth. The
legend. He has, like, at least 2,000 unreleased songs, though.
Does he really?
He drop a lot of music still.
Album a year?
Probably, but, like, this is the thing. Like, his team better not, like, milk the shit out of it.
Oh, they will. So like, we all know they will.
They can't be releasing, like, potentially bad albums or, like, bad songs.
It just ruins his name.
It happened with Lil Peep. It happened with X. Like, his last album.
Yeah.
It wasn't that good.
Because they scrapped the songs for a reason.
Yeah.
But then again, maybe you do want the people to hear what they did.
That but, like, they're dead, did. So they can't give, you know? Like, there's no input. True.
Yeah, who's getting the money at that point?
Yeah. You know?
Exactly.
I mean, I guess Peep went out all right. Like, the songs on his last album were
okay. The day Logic dies is the day the world stops.
Logic hasn't been good since, like, 2016.
I know,
let's be real.
Yeah, but 2016 was when 1-800 came out.
The only good song, Homicide, recently.
Bobby Tarantino. Bobby Tarantino, too, was good.
Confessions of a Dangerous Mind was pretty good. Like, the song, not that whole album. It's like there's only like four good songs in that whole.
I mean specifically.
You mean Keanu Reeves?
Oh my god! This man, every time we go in the car, just plays it.
He plays Keanu Reeves, man. It's a good song.
Put me on the aux this time.
No, I'm not putting you on the aux.
What? Why not? Why can't he? Be
I don't care. I don't care.
I'll be in the back seat this time. I don't give a fucks.
I don't give a fucks.
I don't give a fucks.
That didn't. I don't know how that came. Yeah,
because I finally got Spotify Premium.
Did you get that for Christmas?
Hulu and
I've had Hulu. The only bad downside to Hulu is the ads.
You can pay more for out.
Yeah, but mine came free with my phone. So why would I pay more?
True.
And I use my uncle's Netflix, and I'm gonna be using my girlfriend's Disney Plus.
We use the student discount, so we also get Showtime.
Oh, you got Showtime?
Yeah. We pay
only how much $5. Was it? How much was Spotify premium?
Like $5?
$5.
A month?
$5 and they give you those two things.
Plus the 3-month trial.
Oh yeah, for free.
So I'm on a family plan with my cousins.
Oh that works.
It's unlimited amount of people you can put on it.
You know what other student
I thought it was up to
I
like six or was six or it was either 6 or 14.
I think it's 14. There's like 8 of us on it now. I've had it since like the freshman year.
You know what other student plan I have? Is with Apple Music. It's $5.99, and I get for free Apple TV Plus. It's like all these
Apple
$5.
TV Plus doesn't even have any shows on it yet.
Yes, it does.
It has like that one show
it has
with
C. It has yes. Dickinson. It
I'm
has...
gonna say
no. It's actually good.
Oh, is it?
It's like a Game of Thrones, but blind people. But I don't know how to explain
so
Game
hold
of
on,
Thrones.
Hold on. So it's Game of Thrones, but with Helen Keller.
All right.
Okay. Well, I guess I don't know how to explain it because until you see it for yourself,
no pun intended.
Until you watch it yourself, I can't really give you a good explanation of it.
I want to hear a good joke.
Sure.
What did Helen Keller say to her boyfriend when they were breaking up?
I can't see you.
I think we should see other people.
So I got an Alexa. For Christmas, an Echo Dot, and apparently it can tell you jokes.
Oh yeah.
So I said, so when you say Alexa, tell me a joke. Here's what it told me. I wrote it down because it was very funny. What kind of doctor is Dr. Pepper? A physician.
My God.
Oh yeah, you showed us.
Yep. Oh, I sent that picture in one of the group chats. Yeah. But it's funny.
Wow.
That's a funny dad joke right there.
All right, I got another thing we can do. Let's do Did You Know?
Ooh,
play a little game called Did You Know? All right, here we go. Did you know 11% of people are left-handed?
I did know that.
11%?
I'm one of them.
Aren't you ambidextrous?
No. I think I am. Am I? No.
You said like.
No. I could do certain things right-handed. Does that mean I'm still ambidextrous?
You're ambidextrous.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
That's cool. Did you know August has the highest percentage of births?
Why? Is Valentine's Day somewhere in there? Is that why?
Valentine's Day is in February, bud.
Wait,
is it in February? Is Valentine's Day in February?
Yeah, February 14th.
Oh.
Wait, February is when you make the baby, and then when you have the baby
okay,
is...
Okay, can you stop?
No, when you have the baby is in March,
okay,
right?
Thank you. Yes, I needed to know that.
No, it's 9 months later.
Damn it.
All right, let's just move on.
All right, this is Scott. This went from zero to 100.
Did you know an ostrich's eye is bigger than its brain?
So are they stupid?
Have you seen
that doesn't mean shit.
Have you seen that video where they're at the zoo and the ostrich just comes and just eats the whole fucking container of food that they were feeding the sheep? He just like fucking runs
that, yeah.
Like fucking runs
goes,
just runs over it. And starts, no, it just pecks at the lady and then grabs the thing.
You guys should see what we just saw.
Oh my God. Did you know 8% of people have an extra rib?
An extra rib?
Yeah, like a rib in their body.
Well, I know what a rib is.
Well, maybe you're talking like a rib that you eat.
No, that's also a rib.
Can't wait
from
for
the body.
I can't wait for that Bruno's pizza.
Mm. Oh yeah, that's the highlight of the day right there.
Bruno's pizza.
Not Star Wars.
Oh yeah, Bruno's pizza.
Did you know rabbits like licorice?
Really?
It's probably like a snack you can give them. You know?
Huh.
So like we feed Santa cookies and milk, we give the Easter Bunny licorice.
I'll remember that.
Why does it not work that way?
This is very interesting. Did you know birds need gravity to swallow?
Isn't that why they like notice when
Ryan,
they swallow
when they gulp, they go up and they gulp.
Yeah.
Everyone needs gravity to swallow. Right?
No, there's people
right?
There's no
No,
there's,
you can like I don't
There's
know
no
how to
there's no gravity
it.
In
like,
space it, and those people eat.
You can
yeah.
like swallow
they really
you,
have
like
to swallow.
Exert a force to like
Oh, so birds don't have anything to help them swallow. It's literally all
they don't,
reliable on
They
gravity.
Don't really have a tongue, do they?
No, birds just have their beak.
Yeah.
No, some, no, they have tongues.
Yeah, some yeah.
Probably not as
No, not like pigeons. I'm talking like, you know, like robins. I think robins have tongues. And, like, cardinals.
I know hawks. Wait, do hawks have tongues?
I don't know.
My brain is hurting.
I don't know. Let's move on.
Did you know goldfish can see both infrared and ultraviolet light? Did you know? Oh, another thing. Did you know you can have a goldfish with Down syndrome?
I think you can have any.
Yeah,
anything with Down syndrome.
Anything can have Down syndrome.
I know, but I was at the pet store getting my dog a bed. And there was a goldfish with its eyes, like coming out of its head. And the lady's like, yeah, that one has Down syndrome. He's not going to make it the weekend. I felt so bad. I'm like, I kind of just want to buy the fish so it doesn't have to live here and die here.
My God.
Fish don't make it past the week anyway.
Yeah, they do.
No, some fish do.
I had a fish. His name was Yoshi because he was green.
Oh, my God.
He had green and white spots on him, so I called him Yoshi.
That's the stereotype is that fish don't live very long in captivity.
Yeah.
Oh, captivity. Oh.
Yeah, my dad, when he was younger, he had a fish, and he didn't even make it, like, a week.
Damn.
Yeah.
Did you know money is the number one thing that couples argue about?
No shit.
Kind of figured.
Yeah, that's kind of makes sense. Did you know cats spend 66% of their life asleep?
They are lazy, lazy mother truckers.
All right, here's another one. Huh, I'm scrolling down because some of these are kind of stupid.
That's what you want. Stupid.
Did you know spiders are arachnids and not insects? Yeah, I kind of knew that.
I knew that, yeah.
I knew that.
Really?
Wait a
Did
second.
You know M&M's chocolate stands for the initials of its inventor, Mars and Murray? Yeah, the company's Mars
that.
And Murray.
No, I thought
Did
it
you know,
stood for M&M, the rapper.
No, the rapper's name is actually a play on his initials. Because his real name is Marshall Mathers.
My God. The more you know.
Yeah. All right, hold on. Let me keep scrolling.
Name, even in the name, his wordplay is genius.
Oh my God! What was one of them from his songs?
In Cinderella Man, he says like, said something like, "My potatoes baked, the veggies on my plate can fly."
Like this
my
is
my filet is smoking weed, the stakes are high.
This is a stupid question, but did you know Coca-Cola originally contained cocaine?
No, crap.
It was coca. It was the plant that makes cocaine.
Yeah.
That's synthesized into cocaine. Yeah, coca.
They used leaves.
Did you know the first Burger King? Hold on. Burger King was open. What is the thing you say? You say it, Burger King. Beast Burger.
Kurgerbing.
That's it. Kurgerbing. Did you know the first Kurgerbing was opened in Florida in 1954?
Wait, when did McDonald's open?
1950 something. Because of that movie, The Founder. Still have yet to see that movie.
Oh, yeah.
Want to see it.
Michael Keaton.
Who also, if you didn't know, was the voice of Chick Hicks from Cars.
Yes,
you
know. I do. Why didn't they do the third one?
Because they couldn't get him. Conflicts.
Really? Did you know?
Conflicts with Spider-Man, I think.
Really? They're the same company.
Doesn't matter.
Also, did you know that he played Batman in the 1989?
Yes, film?
Yes,
I knew
Batman. We knew this.
You mean the other original? You mean the only good Batman other than Christian Bale?
When he had hair?
Michael Keaton. Yeah.
George Clooney sucked with bat nipples.
Sucked with bat nipples.
It sucked with bat nipples. I'm telling you.
On his easily suit, the worst.
On his suit.
No, there's that one guy that played it for like one movie.
Was it Val Kilmer?
Batman Returns, right? I mean, no.
Val Kilmer, yeah. He played it for
with
one.
With the Riddler, that one.
I think it was the.
No, the one with Riddler. Right? The one with Riddler and Two-Face is still Michael Keaton.
No.
Not Michael Keaton. George Clooney.
No.
That's
Poison Ivy and Bane.
No, he was in two movies. George Clooney was in two movies, I'm pretty sure.
That's the name.
That's it. Batman Forever. Have you ever seen the Angry Video Game Nerd where he plays Batman games?
And isn't that like the worst one too?
Yeah, Batman Forever. Because you press up to jump instead of B.
There are a lot of games with weird jump controls.
Oh yeah.
Oh, so many.
Like the Elder Scrolls and like Fallout. Why do you press Y to jump on the Xbox? You press Y, not like A.
Well, yeah, sometimes you have to do combo moves, though.
No,
please, thank you, Chewbacca.
It's an open world RPG. Solo.
We're just ignoring what you're saying. I'm sorry, what?
It's not even a fighting game.
What game? What game are you talking about?
Yeah, what?
I was talking about Elder Scrolls and Fallout.
Oh, were you talking? I'm sorry.
See how it is.
I made a Chewbacca noise and then, you know, just kind of went along with it.
Yeah. So, we're going to conclude this episode one of the podcast. I really don't know how to end this, but I'll probably end up putting a song.
We're not mean. Wrong podcast. Oh,
hey,
no.
Hey,
oh,
we're not no. mean. We're not. Oh, wait,
no. We're not men. We're not mean.
I'm probably
going to
end up putting
wrong podcast.
Probably going to end up putting a song at the end of the podcast anyway, so I don't know what I'm going to put yet.
So this has been Dom's podcast. Everyone say goodbye.
Episode 1.